Good morning, everyone. I don't know about you, but life is crazy for me right now. It's the holiday times. We just got done with a week off of school for Thanksgiving. We've got another couple of weeks off coming up around the Christmas time. My little kids know that Santa's impending arrival has, of course, got them bouncing off the walls at all times of day and night. To boot, I'm also leaving my career as Chief of Public Relations or Public Affairs at the Oklahoma State Department of Education and launching a new consulting business, moving my kids to Dallas here right before Christmas time to be with my husband, starting, of course, new career, new schedule, new friends, new life, new everything. It's a struggle to manage it all, right? I mean, life hands us more than we feel like we can choose sometimes. So how do we manage to survive the chaos of it all? I have a couple of things that I just wanted to share with you all quickly this morning. Two tactical pieces of advice as to how to manage the chaos in this crazy season of life. And one a little bit more, I'm gonna call life skill oriented. So first and foremost, every morning as I'm drinking my coffee, I have my Stick-It notepad that's right, in my junk drawer right by the coffee area. And I typically write down my top two or three things that I've got to get accomplished that day and start thinking about what do I need to be, thinking about doing, for the week to come as well too. So always writing down, what it is that I absolutely need to accomplish in order for me to feel good about my day and that I'm achieving something. Number two is my Google Calendar. Holy moly, I use my Google Calendar all the time. I put in all my reminders for everything. So that might be picking up the dry cleaning or picking up something at Whole Foods on the way home from work or whatever. But I also invite my husband for some of these reminders as well too, because if he can easily pick up something, then hey, that's great as well too. So Stick-It notes, looking at what are my to-dos for the day, utilizing that Google Calendar. Gosh, I use it all the freaking time. So I encourage you to do that. But thirdly, and probably most importantly, some work that I've been doing over the past year is managing my mind, managing my thoughts. And that's a heck of a lot easier said than done. But I do believe that we choose our attitude. And in order to choose your attitude, I talk to my kids about this all the time too, for that matter. In order to choose your attitude, you really do have to stop and think about what's holding you back. What are you fearful of? What are those things? Are you fearful of other people's opinions? Are you fearing change? Are you fearing making the wrong move? What exactly are you fearing? What are those negative thoughts? I've been asked by a lot of people lately, how am I feeling about moving to Dallas? And I can tell when they ask me this question, they have this look in their eyes like, okay, you've been in Oklahoma for 44 years. How in the world aren't you scared to death about moving to a new community? And I have to say, and this has taken some thought work, but I have to say my answer is bring it on. Bring on the new life. Bring on the new community. Bring it all on. I want to be able to show myself and my kids that I can do anything that I put my mind to. And in order to do that, you've got to wrangle those thoughts in your head and choose your attitude and get things right, right? Life is full of change. And I do believe that what makes us stronger is leaning into the unknown. You'll never know what you can accomplish if you don't get outside your comfort zone and try a few things, right? And the hard truth of it is that no one really knows what tomorrow is going to bring. So why not try something? Why not get out there and go do it? And here's the deal. For those of us, and I kind of pride myself on being the one that has a perfect plan for everything, but sometimes those perfect plans don't always work out perfectly. But here's the deal. You can course correct. The nice thing is we've got tomorrow. So make use of today. Make it the best that it can possibly be. I also do believe that in order for us to keep our head above water and feel like we're actually accomplishing something, you have to do rather than just plan and think about it as well too. You know, what is it? The analysis paralysis. I know a lot of people who really struggle with, okay, you got to make that decision. You got to do that thing, whatever that thing is. And here's the deal. If you make a mistake, dust off, assess what went wrong, and do it again. I mean, what's the hurt in that? Embrace the chaos, make your plan, and then execute. Those are my words of advice as I'm going through a crazy season myself. I hope you all have a great week. Thank you so much for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you next week too. All right, bye.